Welcome back to Mountain Connections. Right now we have the pleasure of speaking with actor Mark McKinnon. He is starring in the all-new film Waiting Room. It is coming up. Looking forward to seeing it. Mark, thanks for being here today.
Oh, thank you for having me. It's truly an honor, and I'm glad to be here to have a conversation with you.
Well, it's definitely a pleasure to speak with you, to connect with you virtually. And this film, The Waiting Room, looks dramatic, poignant. What a film to be starring in.
Yes, I'm really excited about it. I'm mostly excited about the message that BET Her and BET is trying to get out to our community about making sure we take our health more serious. A lot of times we're waiting to the last minute to go get our checkups, and then by the time you do get the checkup, now the fight is stronger because we waited too long. So we just want to encourage everybody to make sure you get out there and take care of your health. Make your health a priority.
And not only that, this film is written and directed by all Black females. Really has a great message. It's a powerful film, and I'm sure it was a pleasure to be a part of.
It was. I actually got a chance to go to a pre-screening on this past Wednesday, and you can feel the emotion throughout both films because The Waiting Room is a short film series where they're playing two 20-minute shorts on tomorrow, October 17th, and both stories heavily deal with how breast cancer affects the Black community, especially our Black ladies. So we just want to make sure you guys get out there and take care of your health.
And Mark, tell me about your role in this film.
Yeah, so I played Derek DuBois. He is the fiance of a character named Raven Taylor, who's a big social media influencer, played by Jasmine Love, who is absolutely phenomenal in the role. I cannot wait for everyone to see what she does with her character. But you know, my character, he's very strong in his love, and he doesn't want anything to get in the way of the plans that he has for his fiance and the love that he has for her. And I think that this story really highlights Black love. It highlights how love always prevails, it always wins. But it also shows that whoever is supporting somebody who's in that fight for breast cancer, that it's not easy. It's hard. It's hard for the person fighting and for the family and friends who are there to support the person, and that you're not in it alone.
Now, you have been in a lot of roles on some very well-known series. How did those roles prepare you for this one? I imagine a little bit hard or very emotionally draining to play this role in such a poignant film about the topic of breast cancer.
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, just the experience on other sets, you know, it just makes you feel more and more comfortable and confident in preparing your role. I went to school for this, you know, so to be in a position where I paid to go to school to learn the craft, to study hours and hours upon hours of studying acting at Howard University, you know, it really helped me prepare to carry on such an emotional role, because it's not easy to really dig deep into a character who has to go on this journey. So I had a lot of fun. I learned a lot as well. You know, every set I'm on, I'm always learning something. You know, the learning, the education of acting never stops. It was a blessing to be able to learn from Cheryl Lee Ralph, who was the director of the film that I'm in called Like, Comment, Subscribe. And, you know, she taught me so much. She affirmed me. You know, she really made me feel comfortable. And I'm honored I got to work with somebody who I used to watch on TV every day when I was younger.
It's as if everything you've experienced has prepared you for this role. And, of course, more to come. But growing up, you wanted to be a football player and then shifted gears. I'd love to hear about that.
Oh, yeah. So when I was in high school, I was MVP of my football team. I also was a captain of my basketball team as well. So I was doing both in high school. So when I found out I wanted to go to Howard University, the theater arts program, they make you audition to be in a program. So when I showed up to the audition, I actually walked in and they started saying, Mark, we know you're a football player, but you do know we cannot take athletes in our program. And I was like, well, I want to do both. I can manage both. And it was like, no, we don't have any athletes in our program because the schedules don't align up. And I was like, well, I'm going to be the first. And so they said, if you're going to audition for this program, you have to stop playing football. So I had to make an on-the-spot decision at this audition at Howard that, you know what, do I want to play football? Do I want to do acting? This is in the room, in the audition room. And I lied. I said, you know what, I'm going to stop playing football because I wanted to audition. I got this far in the audition process. And I went on an audition, but in the back of my mind, I was like, I'm still gonna play football. And sure enough, I got into the program, I walked onto the football team, and one of our practices, we had a 5 a.m. practice, and it didn't go good. So what does the coach do? I wanna see y'all back here tonight at 6 p.m., and guess what I already had scheduled at 6 p.m. that night? A theater arts rehearsal for a play that I was in. So that was the first time I really had to decide to make a life decision that, you know, do I want to go the football route or acting route? And I felt like, you know what, I want to lean more towards my purpose. I want to make sure I'm doing things that's impactful. So that's when I decided to continue to do acting and hang up my football cleats, which is why one of my dream roles would be to be in a football movie or a sports movie where I get to be an athlete and I'm acting. You know, imagine both roles all together.
Well, I think it's coming. I love that story. What an interesting thing to have start your acting career. And in fact, after you graduated, you founded an acting school. Did you think that you would focus primarily on teaching the craft as opposed to acting, or did you just want to do all of those things?
I wanted to do it all. You know, when I became a coach, I didn't start off in the mindset I want to just start a school. I was already doing it. I was already advising actors, giving them advice. This is how you get an agent. This is how you position yourself to book roles. And then one day my mentor said, you know, you're consulting actors. You know, that's a business. You should take this very serious. And so in 2012, I decided to open up McKinnon Acting Studio. And immediately I fell in love. I was already doing something that I love to do. And so we started off with four actors in the program. And then right before COVID hit, we was averaging about 80 actors per week that was coming through the studio. But to see so many actors right here in the DC, Maryland area on major network shows, cable shows, streaming shows, it just truly blesses my heart. Sometimes I get more excited than them when they book a role, because this is my dream. This is my passion of not only having my own acting career, but helping others to see their dreams as well.
And you've been busy acting, and you have another upcoming film in December, I believe, called The Available Wife.
Yes, Available Wife. That was produced by Megamind. It was directed by Jamal Hill. And starring KJ Smith and Terrell Hill. Both of them were phenomenal to work with. I play an executive of a music company out there, so I had a great time playing, learning that role. And I'm excited for everyone to see that when it comes out in December. It did win, it was in the American Black Film Festival this year, so it was virtual, and it was good to see what the movie looked like.
And of course, back to The Waiting Room. How can we watch? How can we get updates? What can we do to make sure that we don't miss this great film?
Yeah, so you can go onto the BET Her website, or also tune into BET Her on October 17th at 9 p.m. They also have some of the commercials and some footage on BET Her's Instagram page, so check it out.
Well, Mark, it has been an honor speaking with you today. I can't wait to see these upcoming films and really watch your career. I know you're going to go far. Appreciate you taking the time to talk with us here on Park City Television today. We'll be back right after this.